I'm amazed at how far the Pike Road Arts Council has come since the beginning. Who would have ever thought that this gallery would exist and all these artists would be participating in these workshops and shows? The competitions, the plein air event has grown and continued for so many years, and it's just been amazing to watch it. And so I'm excited and honored to have been a part of it. Right. I worked at many jobs, but I worked at Sterling Bank primarily for 13 years, and always with that hope and dream of painting full-time, which I never thought was going to happen. And so what happened was I got involved in the Montgomery Art Guild and won an award at an art show, and that gave me some confidence. Found a magazine that had a story about plein air painting, and I knew that's the style I wanted to paint. Well, then I was hooked. I started painting all the time on the weekends and got better, got in galleries, and so things started to happen, and I think it's because of plein air painting. And so when I started making money with this art and getting a business license, I just saved it and eventually had enough money where I felt like I could quit and do it full-time. I knew I could make money doing it, and it's been a dream. I've been doing it full-time since the end of 2010, and anyway, I pinch myself sometimes that I actually can do it for a living. Plein air painting back then took me a lot to Pike Road. It was, you could safely pull off on the side of the road. Now it's kind of busy, but I could go off on Wallahatchie Road. I was telling somebody today where the school would be built. It was one of the first plein air paintings I ever did, and I won a prize. That's the one I won a prize on with the Art Guild. But I would come out to Pike Road. I would go to Jasmine Hill Gardens, which is closed now too. Go downtown just on the sidewalk. Wherever I could find an open field or a landmark or someplace, maybe paint a church somewhere that was familiar to Montgomeryans. You know, I think I was attracted to plein air painting first of all because of the style that it produced, that freshness. You have to paint quickly, so your brushstrokes are a little looser and you're capturing light. I love that effect of light on the landscape and on architecture, and so those combined, just that's what I loved in a painting. And it really is addictive to try to capture the light in a short time. Oh, that's a hard question. I think the worst thing is to lose your confidence, I'd say rejection from a show or something like that. That's pretty hard to take, but you get over that and you move on and you learn from that. But I think if you just lose your desire to paint or excitement about it, I think that would be the saddest thing that could happen. Mm-hmm. The best thing is that you never stop learning, that you know there's always more to learn, there's always more to explore, there's a different style to go after or a different subject matter or something. There's always something exciting around the bend. Paint all you can paint would be the advice I have for new painters. I was telling students today that one of my favorite college instructors said the best way to learn to paint is to paint, paint, paint. And that was excellent advice. I think that if you have a dream to learn to paint, just do it. Don't be intimidated by it or think you can't do it, because I've seen people who may not have a natural talent for it really develop that just because they had a desire to do it. So don't give up. Keep trying. Just paint all you can.